What's up, everybody? We are back with the next week, and as you can see, I'm layered up right now. It is super cold outside, snow and salt everywhere, but we still grinding out here. Don't get it twisted, man. The grind don't stop at all. But I got my two cars in here that I got my appointments on. I got a customer car right here, another customer car. This is actually a business right here. This is, I think, O'Hare. O'Hare Outdoors. I don't even know if that's showing up correctly on a thing, but this is one of their fleet vehicles right here. We're just basically simply just doing an interior because it is still snowing and it's going to rain and whatever going to come through St. Louis is going to come through St. Louis. So it's just going to happen. But yeah, this car right here isn't too bad. Let me flip you guys around and show what I'm kind of working with. So this is pretty much what we're working with. Like I said, this is a, you know, an outdoor company basically. They make it perfect, but they do all types of landscaping. So there's just a bunch of like rub marks, dirtiness, some dog hair. I did a pre-vacuum on it already, but you can see kind of like, you know, kind of what I'm dealing with. Just a bunch of mud, some stuff. Like I said, I did a pre-vacuum, so the carpet looks pretty good. The seats, I'm definitely gonna have to extract those. Just a bunch of dust and dirt in here, not too much. Just a normal wear and tear on this bad boy. So, got most of the dog hair out of here. There's still some up on a dash. Thank God there's nothing going on with the headliner. But like I said, they do a bunch of landscaping work. So, we're gonna get this back to pristine condition. This is one of the only mat that's pretty dirty. Just got done vacuuming this and taking the dog hair off, so I'm gonna address this one right now and then do the seats. Got the car in here, let it dry out a little bit, but see, we got the whole interior done, cleaned up. The seat is way better. Carpet, back of the seat's a breeze. Let me see here. Oh, it's getting cold outside. Obviously, it's a little, you know, I got salt on the bottom of my shoe, but this seat, you saw how that looked when it came out. Everything is ready to go. They're picking this up tomorrow, so that's going to be cool. So, we're in the next day, cleaning out this Toyota Prius that we got in here for a full detail. But this is one of those ones that It's definitely gonna have to be an extra charge going into here. Many people wonder why detailers may throw an extra charge on there for excessive dog hair or something like that, or you know, tree sap removal or stuff like that that we're not told up front, or maybe like throw up or something like that. But yeah, excessive dog hair is probably like the number one thing you'll probably get an extra charge on. We'll obviously let you know, but you can see a gray interior, black dog hair of some sort. Just got done getting it out of here and obviously out of the trunk of the car, but you can see kind of what we're dealing with as far as like dog hair. It was all up in the trunk and the floor mats. I still gotta do a pre-vacuum down here, but this is gonna be kind of difficult because it has, you know, like a dark gray and a light gray weave in the carpet, so it'd be kind of hard, but pretty much see what I'm dealing with here. I'm just using the pet stone and my wire brushes. That's kind of gonna help this out a little bit, but this is why I'm throwing an extra charge at this customer, because not only is it in the full car itself, but it's literally on the entire headliner. Obviously this is where the dog comes out and, you know, licks the windows and stuff, but you can see it's everywhere. Every section of the car, really on the, right by the windows, but it goes all the way up to like the sunroof. And you know, stuff like that, all the way over here too. And it's just scattered everywhere, except for obviously in the front, but everywhere else in the back of the vehicle, it's got dog hair on there. So, what a great way to start off this day. I may even call this an early day after this, because shoot, my shoulders are gonna be on fire. But yeah, still waiting for that customer to come pick up their, you know, company car. But we got this one. It's cold still out today in St. Louis. It's like maybe like 7 degrees or 10 degrees now, but earlier it was like 2. I didn't even want to wash the car, but I went ahead and did it because they said they still wanted it, but oh well. Last night we got a ton of like sleet, so the highways were super icy and jacked up, so a ton of people crashed and slid off the road. But that's kind of what we're dealing with today. We'll probably just do this car for today and call it quits. Did have a couple of appointments lined up for today, but I'll probably push them back. Man, so am I on the air? I'm on the air. Man, so yo, this hood is scratched. They got some tree sap on here. I gotta bring you guys in and see what this hood look like, man. Sheesh. Check those out. Those are totally gnarly, bro. Totally gnarly, bro. This week was definitely short-lived. Definitely a couple cars I did not get on camera. I was just trying to get out of there. I've been super tired for some reason this week. But this week in St. Louis or in the Midwest, or if you're down south, it's been cold, man. I have friends in Texas that got snow. Folks out there in Kansas got snow, man. It's crazy. We got snow out here. We got hit. Right now, it's literally like 4 degrees out here. So that just kind of lets you know what type of week it's been. Next week is supposed to be a little bit better. So probably won't have that many customers rescheduling and canceling of some sort. So yeah, another week in the books. I'll see you guys on the next one.